Hello, Damo here, and welcome to another Windows-based video. I have recently updated and reconfigured my computer, and for some reason, I don't know why it's happened, there has been this little activation pop-up that you can't seem to get rid of. And every single time I try it, they say you have to go out and rebuy a new key. Now, this was originally downloaded and updated via the website. It was a free Windows 10 download when they were giving it away for free. Now, I don't know if it is because of the actual time limit has gone out, or if it's just the fact that because also I've uploaded to Windows Anniversary, which is a celebration of the year gone, the first year of Windows 10. Now, this only popped up when I reconfigured by putting in a new motherboard and a new processor. Now, the new motherboard that I put in is an ASUS 970 Gaming Pro motherboard with an AMD FX 950 processor. An 8370 processor, which is a brand new processor that AMD have just released with the Wharf cooler. Now, it took me a bit to get it into the computer, to get it into the case. But once I got it all installed and everything and reconfigured and everything like that, this little pop-up seemed to have popped up. Now, I'll show you what happens when you actually try and do it. So, basically, you go to settings, you go to this find window, and you type in app. Activation, right? It brings it up, says we cannot activate Windows on this device because you don't have a valid digital license for this product. Go to the store and buy a genuine Windows, right? And it gives you that error. So you go to the game store, the Windows store. And then it pops up like this. Right. So. Yeah, so it pops up like that. Now, this was a free download. Now, I don't know why it's doing that, unless there's an inherent bug in Windows, so I might have to reinstall the Windows, which is a bloody ass because I've already just reinstalled it because I had so much problems with the previous motherboard, which was the reason why I bought this thing. So if anyone has any other ways to go around it, because I might actually have to reinstall it. I probably will. I'll do it in the next couple of days after this recording. But if anyone has any other sort of helpful tips of how to get rid of that pop-up and to get the Windows activated on a free official download, both of them have been free downloads. Both of them have been given to me free via the official Windows system, and now it's asking for 190 quid. Now, if that is what Windows gimmick is, then I don't want Windows. I'll just reinstall Windows 7 and put up with the joystick problems that I had and everything like that. So it's a really annoying thing. Right, and to finish off this video, I'll just show you exactly what I've installed. So that is my new processor, a U7 AMD Athlon X4. Now I've got an AMD FX 8370, and it's a 4 gig processor, but can be unlocked up to 5 gig. But I will need a cooled system on here, which you don't at the moment. So that's its current speeds and everything. And the good thing about this one is, unlike the other board with the other processor, didn't have a cache L3, this has got an 8 meg L3 cache in it. So yeah, right, yeah, so there's me L1 cache, L1D, there's me two L1s, there's me L2, and there's me L3. The motherboard, as I said, is an ASUS Tech Computer Incorporated 9970 Gaming Pro Aura. I've had to take out the RAM has gone down to 16 gig because I had to take out a single, because they had a single banded RAM stick in here, if I can remember. Yeah, which was a Samsung RAM stick, which I've had to take out. So, that's it. I've still got the same graphics card. There we go. That's the computer. I mean, it's working all right. I mean, apart from the ASUS 3 won't, the new one won't install, which that might mean I need to reinstall Windows. But it's just a complete and utter arsehole. And when I actually get it sorted out, that is the new game that I managed to download, which I'm really looking forward into playing that. But anyway, this seems to be it for this video. I just thought I'd upload another video and warn you all of this inherent problem. It only seems to happen if you actually reconfig your motherboard and your processor, or probably one of the two. So it's probably down to your configuration, because it probably acts as a brand new install. Even though it's the same computer, it recognises it probably as a different computer. So I might actually have to reinstall it. Right, anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope it's been interesting for you. I will be uploading more videos in the near future, hopefully within the next couple of days, once I get this computer sorted out, and I shall see you then. Okay, please do like and subscribe, and thank you for watching. Thank you, bye for now.